Mayor Nagin's troubles are now federal. Jury selection underway in the federal corruption trial of the one-time New Orleans mayor, the Democrat Ray Nagin. He led that city, or something like the word led, I don't think it's appropriate, during and after Hurricane Katrina. But a federal grand jury has now indicted the one-time mayor of New Orleans on 21 counts of corruption, from bribery to wire fraud to money laundering and filing false tax returns. Prosecutors say most of it happened in the very time that the people of New Orleans were trying to recover from the aftermath of Katrina. The feds say Mayor Nagin accepted more than, get this, $200,000 in cash and wire transfers, vacations to Hawaii and Jamaica, among other items, in exchange for city contracts. Mayor Ray Nagin has pleaded not guilty to all of it, but he faces the possibility of 20 years in prison. It's been more than 8 years now since Hurricane Katrina decimated parts of New Orleans. The storm killed an estimated 1,500 people. It did an estimated $80 billion in damage. It forced thousands and thousands of people from their homes. New Orleans, of course, is still recovering all these years later. Lisa Giovinazzo is a defense attorney, and she joins us live from the Fox News deck to talk about the ramifications of all of this for Mayor Nagin. We're not talking about little matters here or easily overlookable matters. The list is long, and it's frankly ugly.
It's a long investigation. So obviously, 21 counts. He's facing stiff penalties, 20 years in jail if convicted of the charges. Right now, it's just beginning, right? This is jury selection. It's in federal court. So at this juncture, the judge really takes the lead. She'll oversee the voir dire, the jury selection. There are certain rules in place. She's likely to ask questions of this full pool of jurors. And the defense and prosecution will submit probably hundreds of questions. And it's up to the judge whether or not she asks them. And once we see this jury pool, we'll start to see how it's starting to unravel.
Interesting to me, two businessmen who face charges related to this have pleaded guilty to making payoffs and are admitting to paying kickbacks to the sheriff of nearby Plaquemines Parish, which was also underwater, after winning a project management contract there. Nagin was indicted in 13, charged with accepting gifts that totaled more than $200,000. The feds are getting help on this.
They're getting a lot of help. It was a long investigation, and obviously his defense will be something like, well, you know, I'm the mayor of this ravaged
area.
The
place he called Chocolate City, yeah.
Exactly, yep. After Hurricane Katrina. And he's going to say, I tried to give the contracts locally, right? That will be his defense. I tried to keep it more homegrown. Of course, at this point, where we are now is, there have probably been a lot of wiretaps going on in a federal investigation, and you have people that have turned against him. They would need that. They would need that in order to make some of these charges stick. So that's kind of what we're seeing. I mean, we're likely to hear a lot of testimony.
The feds might say that trying to keep contracts local, which makes perfect sense, has nothing to do with the following things: $200,000 in bribes, while Mayor Nagin's own family members received a vacation in Hawaii, first-class airfare to Jamaica, private jet travel, and a limousine for New York City, not to mention cellular phone service. The mayor doesn't get these things, especially after he doesn't send the buses.
You know, well, the mayor isn't supposed to accept them. I'm sure they get offered a lot of things when you're in that position. But we hope that the people that we put in office, right, have the forbearance to turn them down, to know that they come with strings attached, which is really the problem. I mean, the other thing, his family has a business. They make countertops. They got blocks and blocks of granite for free. I mean, these are just things that they kind of boggle the mind that somebody could really think they would go unnoticed.
Some will say, but it's New Orleans. But in this case, he could spend decades in prison if convicted.
Oh, yes. Yeah, he could.
All right. Well, I bet they're watching closely in the Big Easy, and we are too. It's good to see you.
You too.
Thanks, Lisa.